Yet another way to install Windows 11 with only a local account. Microsoft has been frustratingly persistent in basically squashing all of the different workarounds that we've come up with over the years to install Windows 11 without using a Microsoft account. In other words, by using only a local account. Some of the techniques I've talked about in the past may or may not work. Most of them apparently are stopping to be able to work as Microsoft plays this game of whack-a-mole with us. We've come up with another approach that theoretically will allow us to do this. I haven't done it yet. If you're seeing this, it worked. Here's what it is. So we've booted from Windows 11 installation media, and this is, of course, the first screen that we see when we do that. Now, before I start, I want to point out that I have disconnected the network for this machine. So this machine is not online at all. In theory, that normally thwarts a Windows 11 installation from proceeding. We'll see. So this is the Windows Setup program. We've got the very first screen that comes up as usual, selecting our language settings. We'll hit Next. Keyboard or input is, of course, US for me. I'm going to install Windows 11. It's okay. Everything that's here is going to get deleted. We'll click on Next. I don't have a product key. The version I'm going to install will be Windows 11 Pro, simply because that's my preference. Of course, we have to accept the terms of service. You'll notice that this machine actually has several partitions in place. I'm going to go ahead and delete them all so that Windows 11 basically owns the entire disk. So now we have a single disk that has 127 gigabytes of capacity. Hit Next. Install Windows 11 Pro and keep nothing. That's exactly what I want. And off it goes. Right, we've rebooted at least once so far. It might be multiple times for you, and it was several minutes. But the setup process continues. We'll click on Yes for the United States, in my case. The right keyboard. No second keyboard, thank you. Let's connect you to a network. This is apparently where things change. Now remember, I am not connected to a network. This machine is not connected to the internet in any way. The trick is, I'm going to click on this screen just to make sure that it has what's called focus, that what I'm about to type goes to the right place. I'm now going to type Shift plus F10. That brings up a Windows command prompt. Into that Windows command prompt, we're going to type the following. Start. ms-cxh:local-only. And yes, I have no idea what the ms-cxh actually stands for, but it apparently is what we want. We'll hit enter. This is the process for creating a local user account. So that's exactly what we'll do. I'm going to go ahead and give it my usual local user account name and password. It does want answers to these questions. I'm never going to use them, so I just fake some answers here. We'll hit Next. Remember, we are still not connected to the internet. Windows 11 is in the process of completing setup. This is the usual place where you can choose which privacy settings you want to adjust for Windows 11. And here we are, in Windows 11. Now you'll notice a lot of the icons are grayed out on the start menu. Again, that's because we're not connected to the internet. Windows 11 hasn't had an opportunity to refresh what those icons should be. And if you want to confirm that you've got the local account, well, just look down here at the bottom of the start menu. There it is. Clicking on it, Leon, local account. So I have set up Windows 11 with only a local account. Now, at this point, I'm going to quickly switch away from this machine briefly, and turn on the network. And boom, Windows notices that there's now a network connection. It has connected and got its icons. And I think one of the things you'll probably notice very quickly is, since during the setup process, we did not have an opportunity to update Windows 11, which is usually part of the setup process, we can do that now simply by clicking on Check for Updates. And it will find some, because we didn't get any in the process. But that's it. We have set up Windows 11 with only a local account, and it actually wasn't all that hard. For updates, for comments, for the latest breaking news, in case this technique gets whack-a-moled by Microsoft as well, visit askleo.com/180135. If you've got a question, hit askleo.com/ask. If you're interested in subscribing to my weekly Confident Computing newsletter, visit askleo.com/newsletter. And if you're interested in maybe helping keep Ask Leo on the air, visit askleo.com/patron for a variety of different ways you can support my efforts. I'm Leo Notenboom. This is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.